In just his last four NBA games, Chet Holmgren has averaged almost 26 points, 9 rebounds, and 3 blocks, shooting over 60% from the field and over 40% from 3. And in his most recent game, he faced off against last year's MVP of the league, Joel Embiid, where he put up an efficient 33 points on 60% shooting. But when we look back to his first few NBA games, we can already see progression. He would show flashes of his potential, where he rips down the lane off the catch, then finishes this circus shot as he draws the foul for the and one. But he could appear to be a little shaky or indecisive. When he catches it up top, he hesitates on the shot and then settles for this long two. Even on drives, sometimes he struggled with pressure, where here he tries to shoot the fadeaway in the paint and it gets blocked by Evan Mobley. And then later in the game, he takes on Evan Mobley again, where this time he has a really good take to the paint, but when he rises up for the shot, he can't even hit the rim. But then again on other drives, he looked more comfortable, taking the bump on this drive and then squeezing right by the help of Evan Mobley to get to the rim, or using one quick crossover, then using his body to get right to the hoop for a layup. We can see this confidence developing in his game already. He looks more than comfortable on this ISO, taking D'Anthony Melton one-on-one, where he spins off him in the paint to get to a floater. And just like we saw his fadeaway in the paint get blocked earlier, now look at him get to the same fadeaway in the paint against Looney, and he looks much more comfortable as he leans back and knocks it down. In a 5-point game with less than 10 seconds left, it's Chet who's the one bringing up the ball, and he flows into a hezzy pull-up jumper over Joel Embiid and makes it. He's not the quickest on the court, but even when he does get cut off, he can just use his length to rise up and knock down the jumper over the defender. Yet, he does have guard-like skills, attacking full speed downhill, then stopping on a dime with this between-the-legs dribble to flow right into a pull-up jumper. This driving presence is allowing him to show off his playmaking, because you can already tell he has a high IQ for the game. He doesn't have the highest assist numbers, but he still has the on-court awareness of when his teammates might be open. On this drive, just his presence draws three Bulls defenders to the paint, so he makes the quick spin back and kicks it out to SGA for three. This part of the game still needs developing, because on this drive, he could have made the kick out to the corner when Caruso helps too far in, but yet he still slows down, ends up finding Dort on the wing that results in him ripping to attack down the lane. And I think eventually he will get to the point where he recognizes Klay Thompson ball watching on this drive, which could have led to a potential backdoor layup for Jalen Williams, but he still makes a nice spin back pass out, resulting in an assist for him anyways. While he has shown his potential with the ball in his hands, this isn't even the best part of his offense, because over 60% of all his shot attempts are coming from him not even taking a single dribble. Chet is shooting 48% on catch and shoot 3-pointers, which makes it really difficult to help off of him around the perimeter. So the Thunder have been incorporating him in pick and roll action, and with Shea being such a threat attacking off this screen, Chet can pop as Embiid stays to help and he gets an open 3 from it. Sometimes they will even incorporate him with another guard as the second screener, but they'll have Chet be the one popping and the guard rolling, and this causes confusion, because now the guard has to stay with the guard on the roll, and when the big helps over on the screen, Chet can pop out to get an open jumper. Holmgren is just as good finishing inside too, so he can swing the ball flowing directly into a screen and roll, and with his long reach, all the guard has to do is throw it up to get him a dunk. And when he does get a switch on the screen, watch how he instantly runs CP3 right to the block, where he gets the ball down low and scores off this post up for 2 easy points. He's shooting over 70% inside the restricted area this season, but this has more to do than just with screen and rolls, because he's really good at moving without the basketball, getting himself in position to score. He has really good instincts to know when he can get open. On this double screen, there's only one defender down low occupied by SGA, and the defense gets so caught up in stopping a potential three that Holmgren slips the screen and gets a pass for an easy dunk. While I talked about how you can't help off of him due to his shooting, this is also due to how well he cuts down the lane. Because the second he sees his man help on the drive, he instantly backdoors and gets a layup from it. On this SGA post-up, he's just watching Looney, and once he turns his head to focus completely on the post-up, Chet cuts right back door, and Looney doesn't even realize it until Chet is already rising up for the layup. But when he doesn't cut down the lane on these drives, look at how the defender instantly runs out because of his threat to shoot. So Chet can rip right past him, and look at where he takes off from to throw down this ridiculous slam down the lane. We haven't even talked about Chet's defense yet, because it's his length and athleticism that makes him a unicorn on the defensive end. Standing at 7'1 with a 7'6 wingspan, he has some incredible reach. Even this high-arcing floater can't get past him, and let's rewind that, because look at how high he reaches up to get his hand on the ball and tap it off the glass. It's this shot-blocking ability and presence in the paint that has teams fearing him on drives to the basket. Even just him rotating over on this play causes hesitation on the drive and forces a travel. His length allows him to guard along the perimeter, because even though he's not the quickest laterally, he can still use his length to recover and disrupt shot attempts. He's playing back and drop here, and at first it looks like DeRozan turned him on the crossover, but watch how Holmgren turns his hips and times himself up perfectly to get the block. He has such a high reach that he doesn't even need to be in great blocking position on drives. Here, this should have been an easy pass to Batum for a layup, but look at where Chet jumps from, and he just extends out to get his hand on the ball. He can go from helping on the drive having a foot in the paint to just needing one step out to contest the three on the pass. And of course, he still needs to put on muscle and build to his frame because he can get pushed around at times, but even here, he looks like he is completely sealed under the basket, but he just reaches right up to block the hook shot. And a similar situation happens again, where it looks like he's beat on the spin move, but he can rise up quickly off the ground to block the shot at the last second. All of these tools Chet has are slowly appearing as each game passes on both the offensive and defensive end. He is continuing to develop and look more comfortable, allowing him to, just at the age of 21, help lead the Thunder to their recent success and become an NBA rising star. If you enjoyed watching this video, then make sure to subscribe and check out one of these videos right here.